Let's imagine that you are gazing out of your window, enjoying a starry night through your powerful telescope. Suddenly, you witness a meteoroid approaching our Earth, and you begin to wonder what will happen. Will the city be destroyed instantly? Will Godzilla and King Kong stop fighting for a moment and work together to catapult back the meteoroid to outer space? Gravity. As we have discussed in our previous video, everything on Earth is affected by its gravitational field. The Earth's gravity is a powerful force that keeps our moon revolving around the Earth and keeps the atmosphere from escaping so we can breathe for our life. As a result of that force, everything on Earth is subject to gravitational acceleration. You may not notice it if you are walking on the surface of the Earth, but when you are jumping from a plane, you will surely feel it. The same acceleration is also applied to the falling apple on Newton's head, or yard, which helps him to think about gravity. The exact magnitude of the gravitational acceleration, or g, is 9.80665 meters per second squared, or practically 10 meters per second squared. The gravitational acceleration is the same for all objects, irrespective of its size or mass. In a vacuum, where there is no air, the acceleration takes a full effect, resulting in objects experiencing a freefall. So if we drop a pyramid brick and a fuki leaf, these are the three things that we will notice. First, the velocity of both brick and leaf increases with a constant rate of 10 meters per second due to gravity. Second, both are falling downward towards the center of the Earth. Third, as the acceleration of the free-falling objects does not depend on their mass or size, they will hit the ground at the same time. Now, of course, the vacuum condition is not applicable under the atmosphere. The air naturally surrounds us and seeps into the thinnest hole. This becomes the second force that we will discuss today, air resistance. Every time you put your head out of the car, you will feel the wind blowing on your face. That is air resistance. It is the force that slows down cars and parachutes. As air is everywhere, it will resist the motion of every moving object. It has the following characteristics. It always opposes the motion of moving objects. It increases with the rising velocity of moving objects. It increases with the widening surface area of the objects. It increases with the tightening density of air. Going back to the example before, as the brick has a smaller size, hence a narrower surface area for the air to resist, it will fall to the ground much quicker. On the other side, the leaf will fall more slowly and gracefully because it has a wider surface area or platform for more air resistance. When the acceleration due to gravity and the deceleration due to air resistance reach an impasse, the object will move at a constant velocity called the terminal velocity. You're going to need air resistance in some situations, such as when you pull the parachute to save your life after falling off a plane. Or if Godzilla and Kong decided to just let the approaching meteoroid we mentioned in the beginning hit Earth and watch everything burn. A meteoroid is a tremendously fast approaching object. The gravity of the Earth, combined with the vacuum condition of outer space, helps to significantly boost its velocity. But when it enters our atmosphere, the air resistance gets compressed so fast its temperature rises and burns the meteoroid and reduces its size until it barely creates a ripple in the sea. Godzilla and Kong can then continue their fight for supremacy on planet Earth.